Welcome back, friends, to another session of fluid mechanics and rate processes. We looked at some mechanisms of heat transfer in the last session. We talked about heat conduction, we talked about convection and also radiation. So that was very introductory. Towards the end, we talked about the equations that govern conduction and also the boundary conditions. Today, I want to take those equations and non-dimensionalize them and see if we can use some engineering charts or some simple methodologies to get an estimate of the solution to these problems. So let's begin with the non-dimensionalization of the conduction equations. So to do this, we will set up a simple problem, and that is actually a semi-infinite slab. So we will talk about a slab. Let us say this is the center line. So the slab is infinite in the y direction. So it extends all the way along the plus and minus y axis. So let me set up the axis. So let us say this is the x axis. And this over here is the y axis. Let us say the slab is initially at a temperature T0. So, T0 is the initial temperature of slab. So, let me peg that over here. So, this is T0. And let me say this is the reference temperature that I am going to talk about to draw the profiles. Let us say the conductivity of this slab is K and the density of the material is rho and capital C is the specific heat capacity. Now there is fluid at temperature Tf on either side and we are going to apply conditions of convection on the two ends of the slab. So let us say this is x equal to L. So, the half thickness of the slab is L and likewise this is minus L. So, there is a symmetry with respect to the y axis you can think of it just as a mirror image. So, let us say at time t, so I would like to show you here that t is a function of x and t. Because of the way we are setting it up, the problem has become one dimensional. So, because the slab is infinite in the y direction plus y and minus y, so at every station there is no dependence on y as such and you get only dependence of x on the temperature field and of course time. Okay. So at any given time t, let us say this is the temperature t. And let us say in the slab, it is going to look like this. Okay? And let me say the temperature here at the wall is T wall. So, Tw as a function of time is the wall temperature. Okay? I am also going to use the notation alpha, which we talked about in the last session, which is the thermal diffusivity, and that is actually defined as K divided by rho C. Okay, rho is the density and uppercase C is the heat capacity. Let me also introduce the unit normals. So, this is the unit normal on the positive x face of the slab and this is the unit normal on the negative x face. And as you will see, this actually points in the I direction, the positive I direction, and this one points in the negative I direction, okay, the negative x axis. This would be useful in setting up the boundary conditions. So let's first write down the equation. So this we had done in the last class as well. So this is rho times C del T by del T. This is kappa or K del square T by del x square, that is the conduction term, plus the heat source STH. Okay? And this equation is actually valid for x between minus L to plus L. Okay? So let me call this as equation A. This equation now needs to be solved with certain boundary conditions and initial conditions. So let us call first the initial condition. The initial condition is given as t at all x and at time t equal to 0. This I am going to call as simply t 0, and that is uniform. So it is not a function of x, although in principle it can be. And let us say this is valid for again minus L to plus L. So for the entire extent of the slab, I am able to specify an initial temperature T0. Now at T equal to 0, this slab which is initially at temperature T0, it is exposed to the fluid temperature and obviously it is going to cool down. Okay? It will not have a uniform profile inside the slab, it is going to depend on x, but of course there would be symmetry with respect to the y axis and the wall temperature will also change. But if you let this slab stay in this fluid for a long enough time, then it is conceivable that the heat would be lost from the slab to the universe, which in this case is actually the surroundings, the TF, the fluid at temperature TF, and the whole slab would come to actually the temperature which is equal to TF. So this heat would be lost, but that would take a long time. And we are interested in finding the temperature profiles at all intermediate times. All right, now the boundary conditions. So let me talk about this as equation number B. And now the boundary conditions. So I'll use two boundary conditions. At x equal to L and at x equal to minus L. So first at x equal to L. So this would be minus k del t and of course del n, but n is the same as the x direction. So I will simply replace it with del x, and this is at x equal to the plus L, this interface over here, and that would be given as the convection boundary condition. So H is the heat transfer coefficient for the film, and this would be times T at L comma T minus TF. Notice this actually is the wall temperature, right, at a time T. So let me call this as equation C. And likewise at x equal to minus L, there would be a condition minus k del t by, again I will have to put a del n, but as you can see n in this case at x equal to minus L points in the minus I direction. So if I want to put a x here, so there would be, I will have to replace this with a positive sign. This at x equal to minus L is actually going to be given as H of T minus L T minus TF, and let me call this as D. Okay? So now I have the equation which is named as A, the initial condition which is B, and then two boundary conditions. There's another simple condition that would be automatically satisfied. You don't have to impose it. So maybe I should write that down here. So another condition that is satisfied actually on its own is that y equal to 0, x equal to 0, that means along this line I am going to have symmetry. So that's symmetry about x equal to 0, and that actually would imply that del t by del x at x equal to 0 is 0, which actually is the same thing as saying that there is no heat flux at the slab center line. Okay, so at the center of the slab, the heat flux is 0 by definition. You don't have to invoke this. This would be automatically satisfied, so I am not even numbering it. All right. Now, the next step that I want to take is, I want to non-dimensionalize these equations. Okay. So, for the same, I will propose some variables, non-dimensional variables. So, let's propose these variables, just like we have done in fluid mechanics. So first comes x star, that's going to be given as x by L, and in this case L is the half width of the slab. You can argue, why don't I use 2L? You can do that, okay, but I prefer to choose x equal the non-dimensionalization constant as, or the characteristic length as, capital L. We are going to do something for temperature. So T star is going to be non-dimensionalized with tau, and we don't know at this point what the value of tau is. So let me make a note here that we do not know what tau is. So I just put in a number. For example, you could think of tau as a half-life of the process. You know, if I take a very long time, infinite time, then as I said, the slab would go down from a temperature T0 to TF. So that's infinite time. But I could ask myself, what happens? What is the time at which the temperature at the surface of the slab is the average of the initial temperature and the fluid temperature? So the time taken to achieve that could be, for example, tau. Okay, so I could come up with different ways of identifying what the characteristic time is. At this point, I am simply saying I don't know, but I know there is some characteristic time. We'll see how it goes. Now about theta. Theta is the non-dimensional temperature, and I would like you to notice that as far as the heat equation is concerned, temperature itself doesn't appear directly, it appears as a derivative, right? So this is your equation, the temperature equation, and you can see there's a derivative of temperature, here time derivative, and then there's a space derivative. So I could actually subtract from it a constant, and the equation doesn't really care for it. But of course, I have to be consistent, because that reference would be needed for heat transfer conditions. Okay, so what I am going to do is use the TF as a reference temperature. So let me define this, T minus TF, and this is the difference, T naught minus TF. So we have used TF as a reference temperature. Okay. You could have used something else, or even said, well, my reference temperature is 0 Kelvin, and that's fine as well, or room temperature. Now what we are going to do is plug this into equation A, the initial condition and the two flux condition, and non-dimensionalize them. So plug these in A, B, C and D. Okay. Now we've done this for fluid mechanics, so I'm not going to bore you with the details. You can try them on your own. So it's very simple. For example, you can work out what is T. Okay. So T is simply theta times T naught minus F plus a TF. And now you go back and substitute for T in terms of theta. Likewise, you do the same thing for small t, which is time, and then x. Okay. So if you do that, you will get the following. So I'll just write down the equation for you. So the time dependent term is delta theta star by del t star. This is alpha tau by L square delta square theta star by delta x star square. So that's the conduction term or the diffusion term plus the source term, which is this times rho capital C T naught minus TF. So let me call this as A prime. So that's the non-dimensional heat equation. Okay. And then what about the boundary conditions? Of course, this is valid for x star now less than equal to minus 1 to plus 1. So your slab also gets non-dimensionalized. Instead of x going from plus minus L, x star goes to plus minus 1. Now the boundary condition. So I can substitute in first the initial condition. So that's your initial condition. And if you do that, the initial condition becomes theta star at x star comma 0 is actually 1, and this is valid for x star plus 1 to minus 1. So this is your B prime, okay, the initial condition. What about the flux conditions, on the temperature? So I will write them down as well. So that would be delta theta star by del x star. So first at x equal to plus L, which becomes actually x star equal to plus 1, and this is given as minus h L over k times theta star of 1 comma t star. Okay. So what we are saying is that the temperature gradient, the non-dimensional temperature gradient at x equal to 1 is this quantity times actually the non-dimensional wall temperature at that instant. So this is C prime, and I will put in the D prime also here, which is del theta star by del x star at x star equal to minus 1, and this is given as h l over k theta star of minus 1 comma t star. This I will call as d prime. Okay. So these now are my non-dimensional equations. So that's the equation itself, A prime, the initial condition at B prime, and then the two flux conditions, the convective flux equal to the conduction flux, that's the condition C prime and D prime. Now from this, we identify certain non-dimensional numbers.